Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. Now it's nearly time for London Marathon as we film this video, which for me is the most fun race in the world. But it's also one of the most famous races that everybody knows about. And it set me thinking about what are the other amazing fun races in the world. So I put my thinking cap on, made a list of some races that I've done, some races that we've helped people coach, and some races which we've heard about, and they just sound amazing. So sit back, relax, let's get the most fun races in the world. Done. Number 10 on the list, we are heading to the northern parts of Spain for a race called Zegama, which is around about a marathon distance with 5,000 meters of climbing. Really one not for the faint-hearted. But the atmosphere on this course is amazing, as you can see now on the screen with the runners climbing up Aizkorri Mountain. Around 30,000 spectators line this course to create one of the most amazing atmospheres you'll ever see in trail running. It's part of the Golden Trail series. If you're interested with all of these races, we'll link to them down below. Number 9 on the list, we're heading to the west coast of America for Bay to Breakers, a 12-kilometer race where everybody dresses up in fancy dress. It's really one big party. There is one very unique thing about this race, which is all about the centipedes, where groups of around about 13 people must stay attached for the whole race. I don't know how this would work in practice. I'd love to give it a go. And they have this bungee cord that goes between them. The person at the back also has a stinger as well. Sounds amazing. Next up, we're heading to Scandinavia, specifically Finland, for the World Wife Carrying Championship, which is on a 253.3-meter course, mostly on sand. There's three obstacles to get through. There's prizes for the best costume. Around 6,000 people spectate every year, and about 100 people take part. Sounds hilarious. We've got a lot of these weird races in the UK, cheese rolling championships, running down hills as well. But yeah, we thought they would include that one from our Scandinavian friends. Next up, we're going down under to Australia, where myself and my partner Sarah will be racing later on this year in Melbourne. We can't wait for that. But if we were traveling at a different time of year, we'd definitely be doing the City to Surf in Sydney, one of the biggest races anywhere in the world. It's absolutely crazy. Around about 80,000 people, that's like double the London Marathon, take on this race. Around about 14K for this one, and it's just a big dance party throughout. Australians really know how to party. This is really one not to miss if you're anywhere in the New South Wales area. Next up on the list, we're heading to America, also Dubai as well, for the bubble run. This takes me back to when I was at university. Foam parties, bubble parties were just a hilarious way to go and have a dance and get covered in bubbles. I guess the organizers of the bubble run did a few of those and then thought, why can't we do this, but make it last a whole 5K. One really, which is not about the time, it's just about out there having fun. Next up on the list, we're back in the UK. Now, if you've ever seen the Indian Holi Festival with all this powdered paint, it creates this most amazing scene with all this paint and stuff in the air. Well, the organizers of that loved that and also loved obstacle course racing. So bring in the color obstacle rush, messing around with these paints, throwing them at your mates while doing your obstacle course as well. It actually does sound quite hard. You've got 5K to get through here, going through all of the obstacles. It's a lot of music, a big festival, great with family. Families, older kids as well, something for maybe like some team building day. Stag and Hindus, another one not for the time, just about having a good laugh. Right, we're getting to the serious end of the list now. Starting out in the USA, and I really want to do this one, but we're gonna do one in the UK with the Krispy Kreme Challenge. The consensus is this, I'm just gonna read this. It's 12 donuts, 5 miles, 1 hour cutoff. Run 2.5 miles, eat 12 ring donuts, and then 2.5 miles back. They call this a test of physical fitness and gastrointestinal fortitude. Sounds hilarious. I'm sure I will have a good chunder when I do this in the UK. Smash the like button on this video if you want to see me attempt that. We'll just get London Marathon out of the way first. This whole race started out as a challenge between 10 friends, and it's transformed over the years into this national publicized big charity fundraising event. A lot of the students from North Carolina State University have a ritual that they have to complete this before they're allowed to graduate. Sounds an absolute laugh. Right, into our top 3. We've got a race here in the UK, or in Wales, called Man vs Horse, which is just a little bit shorter than a marathon. It began around about in 1980, where runners race over this mountain terrain, and then you've also got people on horseback that do exactly the same route as well. The man has only won 3 times over the years. It's very unlikely you're going to be able to beat the horses, but it is in one of the most beautiful parts of the UK as well. So you're going to have an amazing, fun day out there. In a similar sort of vein, we also have a Race the Train race in Wales, where you have to simply race the train that's going along the side of the route. This one is far more achievable. The train takes 1 hour 47 minutes to do the course, but the winners are usually about 1 hour 20. So yeah, we'll link to Man vs Horse and Race the Train down below. In to the top two, second on the list here in the UK as well, is the night of the 10,000 meter PBs. Cue some of the awesome footage here. Now, this is a little bit of an elite race, so to get in to run on the night, women sub 38:30, men sub 32 minutes for a 10K for a qualifying time, which a lot of us can't do, but what we can do is go there and take in the atmosphere and watch. It is an amazing night of athletics. It's coming up fairly soon in May. There's the Lane 3 beer and cheer. There'll be tents over the course, DJs, lots of good food out there, fire cannons going off, circus performances, live music, just an amazing night of athletics on Parliament Hill in London. And drumroll please, my favourite race that I have ever done, one that brought a smile to my face. This was a long time ago, and I've still got, have I got that bottle of wine? And I've still got the prize. Sarah, can you pass it down? This is a race in the south of France called Marathon du Médoc. Cue some pictures of me looking a little bit younger in my earlier years, but it's essentially a marathon distance. This is what I got at the end of the race. They give you a bottle of wine, which I've still never drank, this bottle of wine from Médoc. And yeah, there's basically 26, instead of water hydration stops, there's 26 wine stops going through 26 different vineyards and producers around the course. Back when I used to drink a little bit more than I do now. There's also a few different food stops on the way. Fancy dress is 100% compulsory. It's just about having a laugh. I think I finished this race in just under 6 hours, and I was really proud of myself because I did have at least a sip from every single one of the wines going round. It's usually coupled with some pretty toasty southern French temperatures as well, so it can get pretty hot out there in all the fancy dress gear. But yeah, such a laugh, and one I definitely recommend anyone doing. If you don't want to travel to France, there's also the Bacchus half marathon and 10K race down at Denbigh's in Surrey as well, as sort of our equivalent UK version. So that's it guys, hope you enjoyed the video. And let me know, have you done any of those races on the list? And also, what is your most fun race you've ever done? It'd be great to catch up down in the comments. Hope you enjoyed that. We're off to carry on getting ready for our next one, and no doubt it will be a fun one as well. We can't wait to bring that to you here on the channel. Lots of love, and we'll see you very soon in the next one.